destruction. With no chance to survive. Make your time. I know you.
You're that fucking guinea who was with Barbara in a jewelry store. I'm in this fucking hellhole because of you.
You got locked up because you're a stupid, crazy fuck.
You know, fellas, my mom was right. There is a God! And he sent you here, you guinea bastard, so that I could pay you back!
This looks interesting. Wanna make a small bet?
I'm gonna break you, Dago! Come on, you grown retard. You and your boyfriend Bob are already dead!
This is gonna be easier than the time you shoved a potato up your mother's ass.
You and faggots for breakfast?
Step back!
Did you hear me?
Break it!
Get out of here!
Move, to use a Move it!
We're gonna give you a little time to think about what you've done. Close it up.
So O'Neill almost took my head off, but I made a stand. And let me tell you something, when you're inside, it counts for a lot more than you might think.
How long are you planning on keeping him in here?
Long enough to learn his lesson.
That's gonna have to change. He in any shape to fight?
Should be. Boys didn't knock him around too bad after the brawl in the yard.
All right, open it up.
Rise and shine, Scaletta. You got yourself a visitor.
My name is Leo Galante. I heard you wanted to speak to me.
Yeah. One of Clemente's guys said I should contact you. Said maybe you could help me out.
Oh, fuck Clemente. I don't provide protection for his guys in here. But I saw how you handled that Mick who's after you, O'Neill. He could prove useful. Come with me, boy. Now listen up, fellows. This is Vito. He's gonna be helping us out. Pepe here's got a big fight coming up against O'Neill. He needs a sparring partner. And from what I saw of you out there in the yard, you're just the man for the job. You're gonna help us out, kid. In return, you'll be under my protection. And who knows, maybe you'll even learn a thing or two along the way.
I guess I can't say no to that offer, huh?
I don't remember asking. All right, fellas. Let's get this show on the road. Okay, today we're gonna work on your counterpunching. Vito, I want you to hit Pepe. Try and bust that big jaw of his. Pepe, you avoid the punch like I showed you. Then use that momentum to throw a punch of your own. All right, fellas. Let's get going. Attaboy, Pepe. Keep that oversized chin of yours down, damn it. Footwork, Pepe. Remember your footwork. Whoa! Would you look at that?
Hey! We supposed to be sparring or training?
Change of plans, big fella. This kid's got fire in him. So now you're both gonna practice your counterpunches. All right, Vito. See if you can do that again. It's a handy tool to have in the box, huh? Most guys ain't gonna see it coming. Pepe here, he ain't most guys, though. Nice, kid, nice. Give me two more of those. All right, one more.
Shit, that had to hurt.
There you go. You're a fast learner, kid. All right, fellas, that's enough for today. Nice work. So how close did you get to Clemente, Vito?
Actually, I never met him. I always dealt with either Henry Tomasino or Luca Garino.
Huh. I can't believe that cocksucker Garino's still breathing.
What was your deal with him?
Well, you know, we did a couple jobs for him, and, Luca said he'd bring us into the family for, $5,000.
What? Typical fucking Alberto. He's always been a crooked bastard.
So what is that, like more than usual?
Yeah, like $5,000 more than usual.
You don't gotta pay to get in, Vito. You're brought into the family once you prove that you're loyal, a good earner. And you can handle, you know, the life. In any case, this is an interesting piece of news. When this gets out, Alberto and Luca are gonna have a lot of explaining to do.
Oh,
jeez.
Don't worry about that. We'll talk about it some other time.
Come on, give me another 20.
Hell of a job with that asshole O'Neill. Nice. Next time, do us all a favor and snap the prick's neck, would you? Nice work in the ring, buddy. A little more of that and you'll be ready for a real fight.
Watch where you walk, Guaylo!
Maybe if your eyes were all the way open, you would have seen me coming, asshole.
Galante. Crooked white devil.
Nice to see you too, Mr. Wu. Crooked? You bet on your own guy and he lost. That's the way it works in this country.
Then Wu, offer you rematch.
I think I can arrange that. You up to it, Vito?
Chinaman, huh? Yeah, get him a stepladder and send him over.
All right, Wu. Looks like you got yourself a rematch. And none of that chop suey crap this time. Now listen, these chinks are quick little bastards. No point in throwing big punches early on. You'll never connect.
All right. What am I supposed to do then?
You hit him quick and tire him out. When he's weak, he'll put his guard down. Then you swing for the fences. Now get out there and show him what you're made of.
Hey, does Vito get a fortune cookie after eating your guy for breakfast?
Have study more. His master will not be happy. This no happen if you use tiger style.
Let's go, Scaletta. You're late for work.
Hey, listen. Vito here's got the day off, courtesy of Mr. Galante.
Gotcha. Don't get used to it, Scaletta.
All right. Come with me, Vito.
What, are we gonna train some more?
Sorta. You'll see.
Morning, kid.
Morning, Mr. Galante. Why, no training today?
Not exactly. We got a challenge from the spooks, and I don't want to risk Peppy getting all banged up before his big fight with O'Neill. So I want you to take this one. It'll be good practice for you. Come on. Now, the guy you're gonna be fighting is a strong bastard, but he ain't too bright. Fights with his heart, not his head. You piss him off, you lower his guard. That's when you let him have it. All right, here we go. Make me proud, kid.
Ooh, looky here. I'ma take this skinny-ass white boy to school. Gonna hit him so hard his mama's mama gonna feel it. Hope you meatballs getting ready to lose.
Hey, win or lose, it'll probably be the hardest work this bum ever did in his life.
Oh, come on, my grandmama hit me harder than that.
Laying down on a job like always.
Yeah, that's the way to do it, my brother. Your little cracker going down.
Let's go, Vito. Put these bums back in their place.
Oh, this boy got as much chance of winning as a brother running for president.
Don't worry, Vito. You got him right where you want him.
Man, who taught this brother how to fight? Hope you meatballs getting ready to lose.
All bark and no bite, just like last time, right, fellas?
Now, Vito, grab him and finish him. All right, kid. Now put
your
his lights.
Your little cracker going down.
Hell of a job, kid. Hell of a job. Here's your cut, Vito. You earned it.
Yo, one of the hacks is coming.
What the hell is this? Some kind of circle jerk?
All right, come on, Scaletta. You got a visitor. Hey!
Hi, Vito.
Hey, Frankie. How you doing?
I'm doing good. Real good. Thanks.
So, how's things?
Well, I got something to tell you. I'm getting married, Vito.
Oh, Maron, that's great. I mean, it would have been nice if he asked my permission first, but... Hey, I'm happy for you.
Vito, you're in jail. Look at yourself. How'd you let this happen?
Hey, I already got a lecture from the judge, huh? I don't need another one. Just drop it, all right?
Vito, there's something else. It's Mama.
What do you mean? What about her?
She's sick, Vito. She's been like this for weeks, and she's not getting any better.
Look, Frankie. Go to Joe's. He's holding on to my money for me. You get her the best doctor you can find. And, you keep the rest as a wedding gift.
Vito.
No, I mean it. Looks like I'm not gonna need it for a while. All right, looks like I gotta go. Look, you take care of Ma. Tell her I love her.
I will. And thanks, Vito. Bye.
Let's go, Scaletta. Those turlets ain't gonna clean themselves.
So, you're the new cleaning lady, huh? Follow me.
Hey, pal, you mind? Yo, practice that shit someplace else. Come on, man, you're killing us.
Jesus, your singing is the second worst thing that happened to me in here.
There you go. Make them sparkle.
Hey,
and hurry it up.
Pipe down now. All of yous!
Relax, fellas. I'm just giving the old pipes a workout.
Any more of that shit, and I'm gonna give your face a workout.
All right, jeez. You guys got no culture.
What's the matter? Keep cleaning, or else. Looks like this one's still dirty. Clean it again. All right, that's enough. Now you're gonna go join the rest of the animals in the showers. Get moving. All right, Scaletta. Get your clothes off and get cleaned up. Would you kindly? What's the hold up here? Move your asses.
Hey, Frankie. We got a little business to take care of here, huh? Why don't you go have a smoke?
Yeah, sure. Have your fun, you sick bastards.
I like your scars, pretty boy. Where'd you get them?
Sorry, asshole. You picked the wrong ass to drill.
We can do this the easy way, or the hard way. Your choice.
I got a better idea. Why don't you go fuck your buddies instead? Or better yet, go fuck yourself.
Okay. I guess you want it rough. It's party time. Let's do that again.
This guy's a fighter, huh? Hurry up, Joe. Knock up more.
Ah!
the hell's going on? And where's Frank?
Dawn, boy, you know the drill. Oh, and this came today. Might want to read it. Looks important.
Mama died while Francesca was visiting me. Instead of going toward a good doctor and a wedding gift, every penny I had went to the funeral.
Mr. Galante wants to talk to you. Come with me.
Good to have you back, kid.
What the hell happened?
It looks like the Mix weren't up for a fair fight. A couple of them jumped Pepe yesterday.
It was a lot more than a couple.
Yeah, well, we sure as hell ain't gonna let this go.
What do you got in mind?
Pepe's got it all worked up.
Took a little persuading, but O'Neill's all by himself right now in the gym. Guards won't be back for a while. You're just gonna give him a good beating, break a couple of bones, same as they did to me. Got it?
Yeah, I got it.
All right, come with me.
Break a leg, kid.
I'll wait out here. If the guards get back early, I'll warn you.
Okay.
All right, go for it.
Hey, O'Neill. I got a little business to settle with you.
Just the man I wanted to see. Come here, Mary! No guards to save you this time. Again, harder. This time I'll finish you. I don't think so. Nice shot, Mary. Me ma used to hit harder than that. I'm not gonna be so gentle this time. Is that all you've got? Try again, little man.
Jesus, what the fuck are you made of?
Oh, you'll have to do better than that, little girl!
Out just fine. They never found out who did it. Leo arranged for me to relocate to his cell. Well, actually, it was more like a suite. Life was getting better by the minute.
So, Vito, what do you plan on doing when you get out of this shithole?
I don't know. I sure as hell ain't gonna go back to work on Flo Clemente, I can tell you that.
Yeah, you're better off just forgetting about that old bastard. Trust me. Alberto's a real cocksucker, and you can bet that lawyer he's hired was just there to make sure you didn't rat. But don't worry. You'll get his. Letting guys into your family for money like he offered you is against the rules. He's gonna have a lot of explaining to do.
To who? I thought Clemente was the boss.
You obviously don't know how things work around here. You see, There's more than one family in Empire Bay. There's three. Each family controls their own neighborhoods. There's a system of rules. And if there's any disagreements, the bosses of all the families meet to work things out. That's the commission.
Great, so what do I do now? Am I in trouble too?
No. Nothing like that. You're young, you're smart, and you've proven you can keep your mouth shut. You're exactly the type of guy everybody wants working for him.
Yeah, but I don't even know who these other guys are.
There's two other bosses besides Clemente. One is Carlo Falcone. The other is Frank Vinci. Carlo is young and ambitious.
The guy's a freaking nut job.
He's new blood, whereas Don Vinci is a man of honor. He respects the old ways.
You know these guys?
You could say that. And Frank Vinci is consigliere. You think being just a regular old man gets you all this? But listen, Vito. I'm getting out in a few months. When I do, you'll see what we can do about adjusting your sentence. Pepe, come here. Have a taste.
Galante wasn't lying. He called in a few favors and arranged for me to get out early. Knocked almost 4 years off my sentence. Now, Joe used to come visit me and, you know, kind of fill me in on what was happening on the outside. But I tell you, as soon as I walked out of that prison gate, it was like a whole new world.
Vito! Hey, you break out of jail?
Ah, jeez, good to see you in regular clothes and on the right side of the bars again. Welcome home. Come on in, come in, come in.
Man, I tell you, lots changed since I went away.
Yeah, I guess it has. And hey, it ain't much, but I hooked you up with a nice little apartment, just like you
Thanks.
Said. Now I got a surprise for you. We're going out tonight to celebrate, and I'm going to introduce you to somebody.
Yeah, sounds good to me.
You're going to need a little cash so you can get things going again. I got a piece for you, too, if you want it. Ah, here. Always comes in handy. So, what do you want to do now that you're a free man?
Hey, what do you think? I want to go back to working with you again.
All right. I was worried they might have turned you straight in there.
I actually met a lot of people and learned a lot while I was on the inside. I had a much better idea about things working.
Good thing, because I wasn't exactly sitting around on my ass while you was in there. Don't worry, though. I'll show you the ropes, like always.
Right, well, what are we waiting for? Let's go.
Jesus, I didn't expect you to be raring to go like this, but what the hell? Come on, let's go see your new place. We'll take my car and go meet your new landlord. You do the driving so you can get back into the swing of things. Just hope you didn't forget how to drive while you was in the can.
Hey, what are you worried about? It's like riding a bicycle.
Sure, but when you smack up your bicycle, it don't cost a fortune to fix the friggin' thing.
All right, I get it. Where do you stand? You're like an old lady.
Yeah. I sure as hell hope so. And if you ain't noticed, cars are a lot different since you went away. You'll see. Your new place is just down the street, right near the boardwalk. You're gonna love it.
Good to have you home. I've done pretty good while you was locked up. But now that you're out, the sky's the limit.
You seen Henry lately?
Nah, not for a few years now. He really felt bad about what happened, you know.
So what you been up to? We couldn't really talk about much when you visited me.
Well, after the shit Clemente and that little asshole Luca tried to pull on us, I got hooked up with the Falcone family and I started working for them.
Really?
Yeah, you'll see tonight. I told you, I got a nice surprise planned for you. But don't bother asking, because I ain't gonna tell you.
Oh, boy.
Don't worry. I've been planning this for weeks.
That's what I'm afraid of.
Close enough. Park here. Go check the place out. It's on the top floor. I already paid the first month's rent for you. And hey, the entrance to your garage is on that side street over there.
Thanks, Joe. I appreciate it.
Hey, and about tonight, we're going to a real classy joint. So buy yourself a nice suit. They won't let you in this place look like an ex-con.
My kind of place.
Okay, here we are. I'm sure you'll find it to your liking. I live in a similar apartment myself. As you can see, it even comes with a telephone at no extra charge. And here's the bathroom, clean and modern, with all the hot water you could ever want. And here is the master bedroom. And there is the master's bed. It's comfy. With room enough for two, maybe three. And it doesn't squeak. Always a plus in my book. I sure hope you like your new apartment, sir. If you have any questions, feel free to ask.
Just one question. When are you leaving?
Now, if you'll pardon me, I have to go and check out another client. Goodbye now.
Yeah, see ya.
Jeez, I thought you was gonna be a no-show. Not bad, nice material.
Thanks. So, what's the plan for tonight?
You'll find out. A friend of mine's coming to pick us up. I met him when you was on your little vacation. And show him some respect. He's kind of an important guy.
Oh, yeah?
You'll see in a minute. Here he comes.
Hey, Joe.
Hey, Eddie. Here I am. How's it going?
Not too bad, not too bad. What, this your buddy?
Yeah, this is my pal Vito. Vito, this here is a good friend of mine, Eddie Scarpa.
Nice to meet you, Eddie.
Same here, Vito. Okay, fellas, I'm dying for a drink. Let's go. Hey, Vito, you want to drive? I had a couple of drinks already. So, you tell him where we're headed, Joey?
Nope. All he knows is that it's a surprise.
he's gonna love it.
I fucking hope so. Unless he got into the, funny business in the can.
Hey, what are you two talking about?
Don't worry about it. You'll see.
Hey, come on. We might as well tell him now.
Hey, you waited this long. We'll tell him in the car. All right, let's go, Vito.
Hey, you know, it would help if you told me where we're going.
Head towards the bay.
Okay, so Vito, what was the one thing you missed the most when you was in the camp?
Freedom.
Yeah, well, besides that?
Booze, broads, baseball, everything.
Now you get closer.
What, are you guys taking me to a baseball game?
No, we're taking you to the classiest cat house in the city, Vito.
Cat house, huh? Wow.
Whoa, you don't sound too excited, Vito. Come on, don't tell me you don't want to have some fun after all that time.
Hey, don't worry, Vito. These girls are real professionals. If you forgot how to do it, they'll get you back in shape in no time.
We're gonna have a ball. remind me not to drink too much. There's something I gotta take care of later.
What's more important than pussy and booze?
You know how it is. Sometimes you gotta do what you gotta do. Hey, Vito, come on, step on it, eh? If ever the devil's plan was made to
torment man, it was you. What is this, the Indianapolis Speedway?
What are you, my mother?
Be better had I never known a lover such as you, forsaking dreams and all for the siren call of your arms. Like a demon, love possessed me, you obsessed me constantly. What evil star is mine that my fate's design should be?
After the lights go down low.
So I talked to Leo Galanti about you, Vito. He said you were a real stand-up guy, and he told me all about the shit that Clemente tried to pull on you guys. But between you and me, why'd you get into that line of work? I mean, we all got our reasons.
Well,
Yeah.
I don't want to end up like my old man. And,
oh, no. Yeah.
Look, I figure nobody's gonna help me, so I gotta help myself.
You do. Oh, okay. Yeah. Okay. Scram, baby. So, Vito, listen. I work for Carlo Falcone, and we're looking to expand our operation. Joe's been working for us for a while now, and since you're a friend of his, we'd like to extend that offer to you as well. What do you say?
Yeah, sure, I'm interested.
All right, let's drink to it. Here's to you guys.
All right.
And to a bright future together.
Touching down.
I can't be drinking too much tonight. I got some business to take care of.
1922. You let other women make a fool of you. Why don't you do right? Like some other men.
Carlo's a real smart guy. He's into, you know, astrology.
You mean astronomy?
Fuck you, you fucking cum dumpster.
Sorry, ladies. Looks like I gotta get going.
Shut your goddamn pie hole. If you wanna use your mop.
You fellas ready to go?
No. Yeah, let's go. Hey, get up, Joe!
If you had prepared 20 years ago, you wouldn't be a woman knocking on the door. Like some other men.
Hey,
get out of
I'm going home.
Get me some money.
Good night, you whores! Hey, where the hell is my car? Somebody stole it! Hey, call the fucking cops, man.
You're staring at it, you lush.
Huh? Oh, yeah, good. Hey, where's my keys?
Vito's gonna drive. He's the least fucked up out of all of us.
Yeah! Next time for us, Joe. More pussy, less poops. So, how'd you like the place, Vito?
A lot better than playing I just zeech in the shower, huh? What the hell's that stink? Eddie, you puke?
What? I wouldn't puke in my own car.
What the hell is that smell then?
Oh, yeah, I'm smelling it too.
Must be Frankie Potts.
What? That asshole puked in your car?
Nah, he's in a trunk.
What?
What?
Hey, it's all your fault, Joey. I told you I had some fucking business to take care of, and you went and got me drunk.
Hey, since when does business to take care of mean dead guy in the trunk?
Hey, whoa. Hey, calm down, Vito. Hey, I spent it. We'll figure something out.
What's to figure? All we gotta do is bury the stiff. I already got a spot picked out, up by the old observatory.
Got a shovel?
Sure, it's in the trunk. And the hole is already dug. All we need to do is check him in and cover him up.
All right. Where's this hole?
There, a little ways outside of town, there's a path in the forest to a small clearing. That's where the hole is.
And hurry it up, will ya? God, I need some fresh air. The stench back here is fucking killing.
Stop. Now, I'm gonna hurl.
When a record starts spinning, each of them so when chicken at the hop.
Jesus, where's this shit coming from? Oh, shit. Whoa, I don't remember eating calamari.
Can't hold your booze, can you?
Dum 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 d
All right, we're here.
Vito, go pop the trunk.
Is that a joke? That's great. That's just great. Yeah.
God damn it, new shoes. Jesus Christ.
Oh, fucking Christ almighty. How long this guy been in here, Eddie?
Just a couple days.
You're gonna have to get him out of there, Vito.
That's just great.
I can't handle the smell.
Some fucking welcome home this is.
Hey, mother.
Hey, here's a hole. Right here. Dump him in.
Finally, done. Okay. Now who's gonna bury him?
What?
I give me a minute to get a hold of myself. Can you just do it? Every time I get a whiff of the guy, makes me have to puke. And Eddie's not gonna be any help here.
Fine, whatever.
Hey, fellas. How about a little music, eh?
You gotta be kidding me.
Good night, sweetheart. Well, it's time to go.
This wasn't supposed to be part of your homecoming party, but it's nice out here, ain't it? I ain't been in the woods for a while.
Yeah, you won't be liking it so damn much after I smack you with this shovel.
The boiler have the cannoli in his hand. Oh, my.
and he's got the instrument in his hand.
Sorry, Vito. Not exactly the best way to end the night, huh? But thanks. I owe you one, big time. Leave Eddie's car here so he can get home in the morning.
You're a good man, Vito. I'll settle up with you tomorrow. Hey, you coming in for some drinks?
It's 3 a.m. Shut the hell up!
Hey, shut up, you whore!
Come on!
Look, you had enough, Eddie. Girls. You're going to bed. Come on. I'll call you tomorrow, Vito. Good night.
Fuck.
Hey, Vito, rise and shine!
Jesus!
Marty, stop fucking yelling, will you? My head's killing me.
Oh. Sorry, Joey.
Stop calling me fucking Joey. What the hell's wrong with you?
Vito, come on down!
Jesus Christ.